Hello friends, welcome, and in this session I will discuss many important concepts. There is next term, that is fiscal drag. This is very important and very conceptual also. To understand this term, you should understand few concepts. Like first concept you should understand is progressive taxation. Right. So in the progressive taxation, suppose we take income tax. So progressive taxation is a system of taxation according to which the rates of tax are decided. In India, it is used in the income tax. Suppose in case of an individual, Mr. A, the tax up to 2.5 lakh is 0%. Between 2.5 to 5 lakh, this is 10%. Between 5 to 10, this is 20%. And between 10 to, more than 10, this is 30%. These are the rates of tax. So as the income is increasing, the rates of tax are increasing. Friends, I'm not telling you the exact tax levels in the country. I'm just giving you an example, right? So this is how the progressive taxation works, that as the increase of the person, as there is an increase in the income of the person, the tax rates keep increasing. Right? Now, this is the progressive taxation. Now, what is fiscal drag? So, suppose Mr. A's income was rupees 9 lakh. That means he was paying 20% income tax. That is 1.8 lakh. For the sake of simplicity, I'm not going much into detail about the calculation. You just suppose this is 1.8 lakh. Now the income of the Mr. A increases to rupees 12 lakh. And this increase is primarily because of two reasons. One is the inflation. There is high inflation in the economy. And there is some salaries rise also. Salary rise or salary hike by the employer. So when income increases to 12 lakh, he has to pay income tax at the rate of 30% for the extra amount. So he has to pay 2 lakh for the initial 10 lakh and 30% for the 2 lakh, that is 60,000. So he has to pay 2.6 lakh amount, right? So you can see there is a sudden jump of 0.8 lakh or 80,000 in the income of the in the tax expenditure of the Mr. A. So increase in the income is from 9 lakh to 12 lakh, but increase in the expenditure is, in the tax expenditure is much more high. So from 1.8 to 2.6. So increase in tax amount is more than increase in the income, right? So because of the inflation and because of the salary rise, the tax expenditure has increased. When tax expenditure increases, that means the savings in the pocket of Mr. A got reduced. Right? Savings got reduced. That means his consumer spending capacity gets reduced. If his consumer spending or purchasing power is reduced, that means demand for the goods and services is reduced. If the demand for the goods and services is reduced, that means supply cannot decrease suddenly. That means the prices of the goods and services will reduce. So prices of the goods and services reduce means there will be a situation of deflation. So deflation is opposite of the inflation. So in the deflation, the prices are rising as compared to inflation, where prices are in case of inflation, the prices are rising, and in case of deflation, the prices are decreasing, right? So you can see, because of the progressive taxation and rise in, because of the progressive taxation, rise in the tax expenditure is more than the proportionate rise in the income, and because of that, there is deflationary condition. So this process is called fiscal drag.
right? So when, because of inflation, primarily because of inflation and because of the income growth, the overall spending of the person increases. As progressive taxation is in effect and ultimately leading to the reduction in consumer spending and deflation. So this is called fiscal drag. So you can see over here, fiscal drag is a result of decreased consumer spending as a result of increased taxation that eventually reduces aggregate demand, which leads to deflationary pressures. So we have seen it is a result of decreased consumer spending of Mr. A. Progressive taxation, whereby individuals are moved into higher tax bracket. So Mr. A moved from bracket of 20% to 30% because of inflation or increased income, is a fiscal policy that results in fiscal drag. Progressive taxation allows for increased government taxation without actually increasing tax rates, right? So the government taxation actually increased without increasing the tax rates. Fiscal drag can be seen as an automatic fiscal stabilizer as it controls a rapidly expanding economy from overheating, right? This is very important. So this acts as a stabilizer. This act as a stabilizer, right? How stabilizer? So when there is high inflation in the economy and the income of the people is increasing, that means the economy is doing good. When economy is doing good, it is good, it is desirable, but this inflation can go beyond the control. If this inflation goes beyond control, it will be undesirable situation, because if inflation increases beyond 6%, especially in the context of India, it will eat away all the savings of the poor people. It will have a huge burden on the day-to-day expenditure of the poor people. It is called unlegislated tax, the tax which is not levied by the government but which eats away the savings and income of the people. So this inflation will suddenly rise. So this progressive taxation, it actually comes as a rescue during the high growth situation, because it reduces the consumer spending by increasing the tax rates, by increasing the tax expenditure, and ultimately the inflation cannot go beyond a level. So this fiscal drag is also having a positive phenomena, right?